heard of me now, please do me a favor, and if you like anything you heard, go home and steal all my music over the internet. Took a big percentage of the proceeds from the third world and we used them to build an orphanage and a school in Afghanistan with Omer International, OMEID.org. No corporate funding, no military break, just the power of underground hip-hop. Your voice, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. How many of y'all been with me since Revolutionary Volume 2? Thank you. Thank you for everyone that's been with me and those of you that are joining me on this journey today. How many of y'all have been with me since the very, hold on, the very, very, very beginning? We're going to talk about the number one most downloaded independent album, the number one most stolen independent album. I'm sorry, it's not a band in the garage, ladies and gentlemen. It is the one and only, and I wear it like a badge of honor, the number one most stolen album that's independent. Just saw a piggy or something, go home and steal that shit, motherfucker, okay? Can I take y'all on a journey with me? I can't fucking hear you! Was making a million, being an endless hustler that the world never seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son taught simultaneously grew colder. He started hanging out, selling bags in the projects, checking the young chicks, looking for hand run across face. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation. Steal. Got locked once again and hesitated to squeal. Criminals and children didn't think he was real. See, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. You feed it for props and addicts with pipes and needles. So he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential. Capitalistic mental, coincidentally dropped out of school to sell weed. Dancing with the devil, smoking till his eyes are bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave it to his greed. Tell you about a little bit. So when he started robbing niggas, anything he could do, he'd get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Started fights over little shit up on the block. Stepped up to selling brothers and brothers can track rock. Working overtime, making money for the crack spot. Hit the jackpot, they wanted to move up to cocaine. The villain is Scarface fantasy, stuck in his brain. Tired of hood niggas, treated him the same. He wanted to be major like the cutthroats and the guns. But when he tried to step to him, niggas showed him no love. They told him any motherfucking coward can sell drugs. Any bitch nigga with a gun can bust slugs. Any nigga with a red shirt can front like a blood. Even puppies on the motherfucker up in the club. But only a real dog can stab someone to the death. Standing in front of them, staring straight into their eyes. When he realized that these men were well guarded and they wanted to test him before business started, suggested raping a chick to prove he was cold hearted. Now he had a choice between going back to his life or making money with made men up on his side. His dreams about cars and ice. Made him agree, a hardcore nigga is all he ever wanted to be. So he backed up Friday night at a quarter to three. You gonna take this ride right now. They go around the project, slow while it was raining. Smoking blunts, drinking and joking for entertainment. Till they saw a woman on the street, walking alone. 3 in the morning, coming back from work, on the way home. So they quietly got out the car and followed her. Walking through the projects, the darkness swallowed her. They got the shirt around her head and knocked her onto the floor. So Billy York and Rocket grabbed a chick by the hair, dragged her into a lobby that had no money there. Struggled hard, but they forced her to go up the stairs. Got to the roof and then they held it down on the ground. Yelling, shut the fuck up, stop moving around. Your shirt covered in face, but she screamed and called. They stole my bitch till he broke her jaw. Dirty bastards knew exactly what they were doing. They kicked her until they cracked the ribs and she stopped moving. Blood began through the cloth, she cried solidly. And then they all proceeded to rape her violently. Billy was made to go first when each of them took a turn, ripping her up and choking her until her throat burned. Her broken jaw mumbled to God, but they weren't concerned. When they looked at her, she was lying, bloody, broken and bruised. One of them niggas pulled out a brand new 22 and told them that she was a witness to what she'd gone through. And if he killed her, he was guaranteed to spot the crew. He thought about it for a minute, she was practically dead. So he leaned over and put the gun right to her head. And now, I have to finish my story for you, Walton. The only way that it can end. Right before he pulled the trigger and ended her life, he thought about the cocaine with the platinum ice. And he felt strong standing alone with his new brothers. Cocked the gat to her head and pulled back the shirt cover. But what he saw made him start to cringe and stutter. He was staring into the eyes of his own mother. She looked back at him and cried because he had forsaken her. She cried more painfully, and when they were raping her, his whole world stopped. He couldn't even concentrate. This corruption had successfully changed his fate. And he remembered how his moms used to come home late, working hard for nothing. Just now, what was he worth? He turned away from the woman that had once given him birth. He cried out to the sky because he was lonely and scared. But all the devil responded because God wasn't there. And back then, he knew what it was to be empty and cold and swim chunked off the roof. Died with no soul. They say death takes you to a better place, but I doubt it. After that, they killed his mother and never spoke about it. And this is the story that I'm telling is true. Because I was there to Billy Jacobs and I raped his mom too. And the devil follows me everywhere that I go. In fact, I'm sure he's standing on my own when he my show. In every street cypher, it's in his little dark snow. Put me standing right next to you and you wouldn't know. The devil grows inside the hearts of the soul that you're wicked. White, brown, yellow, and black color is not restricted. You have a self-destructive destiny when you're afflicted. And you'll be one of God's children that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So when the devil wants to dance with you, you better say never. Because if you dance with the devil, might last you forever. I want to say something very important. If you listen to anything I ever said, please listen right now. Every time I do that song, somebody comes to me at the table or after the show and they say, Tempe, that's such a fucked up story. Is it a true story? Did it really happen? And I say, what are you talking about? It happens every day, in every city, in every country, all over the fucking world. But maybe it needs to be made more personal for the people, so I'm making it as personal as possible without being disrespectful. All the fellas in here, your mother, your sister, your grandmother, the girl you came here with tonight, or the woman you go with today, she might have lost her virginity by being a victim of rape, being a victim of that sometimes during her life, and she might never tell you, you might never know, and it's because women are prouder than men, and they've been forced to suffer twice as much as we have. Swear up in your life, don't mean nothing because you